Black swifts are such a cool bird. I find them so mesmerizing to watch in the sky. They're so acrobatic and like swooping and catching insects. They're so good at what they do.
They spend so much time feeding in the air. They only visit their nest a couple of times at sunrise or sunset.
And then where they nest too is just from a human perspective quite uninhabitable, and nesting on these ledges, like on these sheer drops, hundreds of meters down, above these waterfalls, just a place that humans can't go. I think that's what I find most fascinating.
So here in these wonderful places across the province to unravel a lot of mysteries about the black swift, where they nest, the timing of the different breeding stages, egg laying, incubation, nestling phases, and also the breeding behavior. For example, like how much time the parents spend at the nest.
And furthermore, we have barely any idea about where Canadian black swift populations migrate to spend the winter. So the reason why black swifts choose those inaccessible waterfalls and canyons to raise their one chick is, first of all, to avoid potential predators, and second, they need to maintain those specific temperature and humidity conditions at the nest.
Black swifts are a type of aerial insectivore, and unfortunately, aerial insectivores have been in decline for the past 50 years. It's been documented around 70% decline in Canada, and that's thought to be due to pesticide use affecting the insects that they forage for and they rely on, and also climate change affecting insects.
For black swifts in particular, as they are nesting close to water and waterfalls, it is believed that changes in stream flow due to climate change may affect their nesting success. For the surveys, we wake up very early in the morning and we arrive at the waterfall about 30 minutes before sunrise. And we spend an hour and a half scanning the cliff faces, trying to spot for the black swifts.
It is very hard looking for them, like very remote places that you need to go to. Usually a lot of climbing, hiking, lots of driving up forestry roads. Just getting to the waterfall itself is really challenging. And then once you're there, you are not guaranteed to have a good angle or a good view of the nest. Like, we had to scramble up the side of the falls and try to get like a bird's eye view of the nest, and that was challenging too. Also, the adults aren't always there, so it's only really in the morning and in the evening that they fly to and from the nest. So, yeah, it's really hard to narrow in on the exact location.
They choose the most inaccessible locations to build these very cryptic nests, like cup shape made of moss. And once you find a nest, you're really happy about it, especially when you find the chick.
It's like surreal, honestly, when you get the scope and you zoom in on the nest and you're looking at the adult or the chick, and you're like, you're right there. You're doing pretty well. Like, if the habitat's there and the insects are around, like, they flourish. So there's so much you can do to help protect aerial insectivores and black swifts specifically. First of all, you know, take action against climate change in whatever way you can, and advocate for changes in your local government and also with industry. a big threat to aerial insectivores is pesticide use, so really advocate for decrease or no use of pesticides, and where you can, try to stay away from that. Document any sightings you see. An eBird is a really good place to document that, and also just reach out to Birds Canada. Get involved. You can email us, you can donate, you can volunteer your time, anything helps really.